My name's Eliza Schlesinger, and this is the story of the worst time I ever bombed. To be honest, it's not, like, one horrible story. Like, there are crappy things that have happened. Like, any comic knows the worst is when you do a bar show, and, like, they won't turn the Laker game off behind you. I've had that happen. But I think the most uncomfortable gig was, we got a request, this was years ago, this was, like, 2006, a request from a country club that specifically wanted four female comedians, which no one ever wants all female comedians. People only want a female comedian. It's not true, times have changed. And so they wanted four of us, and none of us were, this is before Last Comic Standing, none of us were known in any capacity, so it was odd that they would pay for us at all. And so we drove out to like some place with a Spanish name in outside of Los Angeles, which is pretty much everywhere, some really nice country club, and it was their like country club clubhouse. And it was, we'll call it a corporate event because it was a bunch of white dudes paying for it. And it was a bunch of like dads, like doctors and lawyers who look like your gross dad, that were having sort of like a dad night. And they were all drunk and smoking cigars. And they, I think their wives were like, you can't have strippers. They're like, okay, so we'll objectify some women like mentally. So it was me and these three other women, and we're up there, and there were strippers there, and they were fully naked. And so like there was a clear line between the female comics, like who were dressed like lesbians, and then the strippers. So like some of the heat was off of us, but they were strippers. It's very hard to do stand-up comedy, especially amateur stand-up, where your jokes are about like traffic and pizza, while you're looking at a guy who's old enough to be your father, with a naked girl on his lap, young enough to be your sister. And we had to do our set with all these strippers and all these wasted guys. And I didn't have enough to do. I probably had at the time like 20 minutes, but it was all like, you know, I'm like a young 20-year-old girl, so it's all about like being wasted and observations, and there's like one herpes joke or something. And then they made us compete for $100, and they voted on who they liked the best. And my friend Christina won. And to this day, I hold it against her that I didn't win, because I did a good job. But yeah, that was the most objectified and uncomfortable I felt doing stand-up in a long time. So to combat that, I don't do all dad country club gigs anymore. Well, I would if they paid all dad country club gig money. They didn't. I did not win the money.